You're watching Tag TV.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
India is well known around the world for its culture and heritage. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India is said to be a land of festivals, where almost each day is celebrated with utmost joy and enthusiasm. The onset of a new year brings new harvest season for the farmers, which are celebrated in the form of a number of different harvest festivals to offer their obeisance to the gods for blessing humanity with food and prosperity. One such festival is Lohri, which is usually celebrated in northern India, especially in the states of Punjab and Haryana, with great zeal and fervor. Take a look. Festivals in India are celebrated with great passion and joy. The auspicious Uttarayan brings golden sunlight and a gust of pleasant wind along with itself. Almost all states in India are dipped in festivities at this time, with festivals like Makar Sankranti, Pongal, Bihu and more. While the entire country worships the sun god and celebrates the offset of winter, northern states of India, especially Punjab and Haryana, celebrate the occasion in the form of Lohri, a winter folk festival.
Lohri is a traditional festival in Punjab. And why do we celebrate it? One of the first people said that a girl is born in the house, so Lohri is born. Now it's also a girl's Lohri. We celebrate Lohri for the family. मतलब खूब परिवार हम मिलके वो लोहड़ी मनाते हैं कि जैसे कि एक आगाज होगा नए साल का
ठंड भी जाएगी
और और आगे बसंत आएगी और नया साल का आगाज होगा ताकि अच्छे दिन आए.
Said to be one of the most zestful festivals in northern India, Lohri is celebrated a night before Makar Sankranti, which usually falls on 14th January every year. The festival marks the end of winter and is a traditional welcome of longer days and the sun's journey in the northern hemisphere by Hindus and Sikhs. People get decked up in the best of their outfits, light bonfires in their yards, socialize around fire and sing and dance joyfully to celebrate the occasion. It is believed that the bonfire symbolizes Lord Agni, and circling around the fire brings positivity in the lives of people.
उस टाइम जो मस्ती होती है वो देखने वाला नजारा होता है और रात होती जैसे आप सब देख रहे हैं कि शाम हो गई है अब अग्नि के आगे सबने माथा भी टेका. लोहड़ी में मान्यता ये है कि जैसे जिस वक्त लोहड़ी आती है तब जो ठंड है जो इस टाइम पड़ रही है वो चली जाती है और लोहड़ी की अग्नि में लोग ऐसा समझते हैं कि अगर हम उसको माथा टेकेंगे और उसमें कुछ धूनी डालकर उसके अग्नि को करेंगे अर्पित करेंगे तो हमारे जो जिंदगी के दुख कष्ट हैं वो भी निकल जाते हैं. तो ऐसा माना जाता है और मुझे भी ऐसा लगता है कि अगर साल की शुरुआत कुछ ऐसे हो जाए तो बहुत मजा आता है.
Also said to be a harvest festival, Lohri is celebrated by people after weeks of rabi crop session work, and therefore it is celebrated by eating sheaves of roasted corn and other winter foods. Traditionally, people enjoy eating winter foods like gajak, sarson ka saag, radish, groundnuts, jaggery and other items during the festival. People also offer these winter food items to the bonfire, as it is believed that offering food items to the bonfire helps take away all the negativity from life and bring prosperity. While the bonfire is lit at night, during the day, people enjoy flying kites and rejoicing the onset of the new windy season.
सब पूरा हमेशा काम करते रहते हैं परिवार के साथ सारे मिलके यारा दोस्तों के साथ मिलके एक जगह इकट्ठे होके लोहड़ी सुबह तो पतंग उड़ाते हैं शाम को अपना गेट टुगेदर करते हैं और लोहड़ी बालते हैं
द वर्ड लोहड़ी इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द वर्ड्स तिलहोरी व्हिच मींस तिल और सेसमे एंड रोहरी व्हिच मींस जागरी एंड इट इज बिलीव्ड that the festival officially marks the onset of spring in the north region of the country. India is a country blended with diverse cultures, religions and traditions. With the second largest population in the world, the peaceful coexistence of all different communities under one roof has always been a wonder for the people around the world. Today, let us take you to a small village in Karnataka, where a large number of people from various religions united to pray for peace and harmony during the Urs commemoration of Hazrat Khwaja Saiful Maluk. Take a look.
Cutting across the religious lines, scores of pilgrims thronged Karajagi, a small village in Karnataka, to commemorate the Urs of Hazrat Khwaja Saiful Maluk. Pilgrims from different religious backgrounds came together in the spirit of humanity and commemorated the Urs or death anniversary of the revered Sufi saint whose teachings continue to inspire generations. During Urs, devotees including women and children offer prayers and holy chadars at the shrine while chanting verses from the Quran. But this Urs was celebrated with much grandeur.
इस जगह पे यहाँ नज़दीक से आंध्र तेलंगाना और महाराष्ट्र कर्नाटक गोवा पांच राज्यों से यहाँ से भक्तगण आते हैं ये जगह ऐसी है जो भी कोई यहाँ पे आता है खाली हाथ से गया हुआ कोई उदाहरण है ही नहीं है चाहे तो भी कोई भी है यहाँ पे आके सच्चे दिल से अगर आप मन्नत रखेंगे तो आपका मन्नत पूरी करने में हजरत ख्वाजा साहिब मुल्क कोई हर्ज नहीं रखेंगे
To mark the occasion, a grand procession was carried out from the Malipatil house, which is inhabited by a Hindu family. The procession included a bullock cart carrying the blessed sandal, which was taken all around the city to commemorate the Urs of the Sufi saint. It was indeed an eccentric view that exemplified the cultural assimilation of the two communities that have been residing together for years harmoniously. Devotees from near and far welcomed the holy sandal with amazing gusto. Later, after the procession, the sandal was taken to the dargah where prayers were offered to the revered saint.
बड़ी धूमधाम से और शान और शौकत के साथ बंडी यहाँ पर पहुँचती है करजगी में और ये देखने के लिए हर खेड़ा और हर तालुका हर जिला और स्टेट टू स्टेट के लोग आकर मजमा देखने को जमे हुए रहते हैं फिर भी इस साल का बहुत अच्छा होने की वजह से हमारे को बहुत खुशी है
The message of peace and brotherhood comes out loud from these dargahs and these sites have been acting as symbols of communal harmony for ages.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Indian Airlines started delivering batches of COVID-19 vaccines nationwide. Preparing for the launch of a campaign to offer shots to 1.3 billion people in what officials call the world's biggest vaccination drive. Vaccinations are set to begin on January 16 in an effort that authorities hope will see 300 million high-risk people inoculated over the next 6 to 8 months. First to get the vaccine will be 30 million health and other frontline workers, followed by about 270 million older than 50 or deemed high-risk. Officials in Prime Minister Narendra Modi's western home state of Gujarat said vaccine distribution was their top priority.
Vaccination dose Ahmedabad ke Sardar Patel इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट पर भारत सरकार की ओर से प्लेन के द्वारा पहुंचाए गए हैं और कल बड़ौदा, सूरत और राजकोट में भी बाय रोड कोल्ड स्टोरेज चेन के द्वारा, कोल्ड स्टोरेज व्हीकल के द्वारा और ज्यादा जत्था सूरत के लिए जो पहुंचाया जाएगा।
मोदीज गवर्नमेंट साइन परचेज पैक्ट्स विद वैक्सीन मेकर सेरम इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंडिया based in the western city of Pune for its Covishield shot more than a week after approving the vaccine developed by Britain's AstraZeneca and Oxford University. Health authorities in eastern and western states said they would make use of experience gained from running regular child immunization programs for polio to ensure full coverage in what they call the world's biggest vaccination drive. A zoo in India's western Vadodara city celebrated the second birthday of hippopotamus Mangal. The calf was born to hippopotamus Dimpy at the city's famous Sayaji Bagh Zoo on the same date in 2019.
आज हिप्पो का जो छोटा वाला हिप्पो था उसका सेकंड बर्थडे है. सो कोइंसिडेंटली वो हिप्पो का बर्थडे और हमारा जो जू का बर्थडे एक ही दिन आया, तो उसका जो फीस्ट है लड्डू उसको भी उसका हिसाब से लड्डू भी खिलाए थे और उसका भी बर्थडे मनाया, तो हमारे लिए तो बहुत खुशी है.
टू मार्क द ओकेजन ज़ू अथॉरिटीज एंड विजिटर्स फेड लड्डूज टू द हिप्पोस विद एडल्ट्स वेइंग फ्रॉम 1500 किलोग्राम्स अप टू 3200 किलोग्राम्स. द हिप्पो इज द सेकंड हैवीएस्ट लैंड एनिमल आफ्टर द एलिफेंट, स्पेंडिंग द हीट ऑफ द डे इन वाटर एंड कमिंग अशोर एट नाइट टू फीड ऑन ग्रासेस एंड फ्रूट. The World Wildlife Fund estimates there are around 115,000 to 130,000 left in the wild. A Odisha-based farmer invented innovative water lifting irrigation system that can bring a revolution in farming and agriculture. Mahur Tipiria, a resident of Badam Talia village in Mayurbhanj district, used bamboo and wasted plastic bottles to set up this water wheel instrument near river. With no education and technical knowledge, Tipiria was able to irrigate his farmland located 2 kilometers away from water source.
यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है, बहुत सारे जगह में हम लोग सोलर के ऊपर डिपेंड करते हैं. हम लोग पानी, जो हम लोग पानी पंप बोलते हैं उसके ऊपर डिपेंड करते हैं. उसमें आप लोगों का किरोसिन पेट्रोल का भी खर्चा होता है, लेकिन अगर हम कुछ कुछ ऐसे स्ट्रक्चर बना दें तो अपने फील्ड में और अपने आसपास के फील्ड में भी एनी टाइम हम लोग खेती कर सकते हैं.
द सिस्टम नीदर रिक्वायर्स पॉल्यूटिंग जनरेटर सेट्स नॉर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. Instead, it is based on a common gravity trick.
India is a country where Sufism has not just flourished, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. Even today, the teachings of these saints inform the lives of people and serve as a guiding force to all. Today, we'll take you to one such darga in Jajpur district of Odisha, where people of different religious communities have been coming together and offering their prayers.
Situated in the Jajpur district of Odisha, the shrine of Sufi saint Sayyid Buland Shah Baba Alahi Rehma has served as a cynosure of communal harmony for generations, which is thronged by devotees every day, irrespective of their religion. Regarded as one of the greatest Sufi saints, Hazrat Sayyid Baba Alahi Rehma throughout his life spread the message of Sufism and peace. Devotees of different faiths, especially Hindus and Muslims, visit the dargah of this great saint who propagated the teachings of oneness and communal harmony.
Muslims se zyada Hindu aate hain us jagah mein. गैर मुस्लिम को चाहेंगे मगर सबको चाहेंगे. जो उनको चाहने वाला होगा वो उनको अच्छी तरह से चाहेंगे, उनको दौलतदार बना देंगे, अमीर बना देंगे. हर धर्म के लोग यहाँ आते हैं, उनसे फरियाद करके उनसे दुआ ना, उनका जो गैर मुस्लिम है उनको नमस्कार करते हैं. हम मुसलमान हैं, नमाज पढ़ते हैं, कुरान पढ़ते हैं, दुआ करते हैं.
Coming from far and wide, devotees attend prayers at the dargah to seek the blessings of holy saint. According to a legend, Baba Bulhan Shah used to reside in a hut near a banyan tree in Jajpur and was looked after by a Hindu milkman. Later, the place was turned into Baba's Dargah, which is revered by Hindus and Muslims and devotees of all religions. It is believed that saint fulfills the wishes of all and nobody returns empty-handed from here.
पीर बाबा बहुत विश्वासी आम समस्ते प्राय हिंदू मुसलिम समस्ते विश्वास करते जेकोसी गोटे विपद पड़े भी ये बाबा को मानसिक कले सब पूरण हुए बहु पुरातन जो आम तो ये शाशुर बो हेक आसीचु आो शशुर जेजे शशुर से मैंने भी मानी ठाकुर को सी कहती बाबा जो जीता समाधि नहीं
Since ages, the Sufi saints like Sayyid Bulhan Shah Baba Alahir Rehma have propagated the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country, and their teachings are still playing a significant role in strengthening the thread of secularism.
Moving on. The Indian subcontinent boasts of immense skills and potential, especially in the fields of embroidery, art and handicraft. A large percentage of population is directly or indirectly engaged in making and selling of indigenous handicraft items. The authorities also keep on taking a number of steps to promote these crafts and provide platform to local artisans in order to showcase their craftsmanship. A similar initiative was recently taken by authorities in Rajkot city of Gujarat, where a handicraft exhibition was organized to promote local handicrafts. Take a look. Handicrafts in India are diverse, rich in history, culture and religion. These crafts reflect the day-to-day colorful lifestyle of the citizens and are also a way to showcase their beliefs and emotions. Men and women in many Indian households are directly or indirectly engaged in weaving and craft work. Northwestern India is home to a number of different varieties of handicrafts and indigenous art forms, which are immensely popular around the world. In order to promote these indigenous handicrafts, and provide a platform to local Gujarati artisans, a handicraft fair was recently organized in Rajkot city of Gujarat.
गुजरात के छोटे छोटे गांव से अलग अलग जगह से यहाँ बेचने के लिए आए हैं, बिक्री करने के लिए आए हैं। यहाँ पे जो 170 कारीगरों है वो अपनी विविध आइटम यहाँ लेके आए और उसके बेच सके और इसीलिए गुजरात भर से ये लोग आए हैं और जो ये काल चल रहा था कोरोना काल इसके बाद ये पहली बार हुआ है तो ये अच्छा रहेगा और राजकोट की जनता को ये अपील करता हूँ कि सब लोग यहाँ आके देखें।
टाइटल्ड हस्तकला पर्व, द फेयर शोकेस्ड अ नंबर ऑफ हैंडमेड एम्ब्रॉयडरी, हैंडीक्राफ्ट्स एंड वाइब्रेंट हैंडलूम प्रोडक्ट्स by small and big handicraft workers from Gujarat and nearby areas. Organized by the state authorities in Gujarat, it allowed a total of 170 craftsmen to showcase their artistry at the grand exhibition. This year, authorities decided to keep the stall rent low for craftsmen to derive maximum profits from sales, which had been previously hit due to the pandemic. A large number of visitors attended the fair and purchased a wide variety of products like clothes, clay pots, jewelry and more.
बहुत अच्छा एग्जीबिशन देखा है और कितनी सारी ऐसी चीज़ें हैं जो हमें बाहर बाज़ार में भी नहीं मिल सकती, वो यहाँ पर हमें अवेलेबल है। तो हमने मिट्टी की थोड़ी चीज़ें और कितनी लकड़ी की ऐसी जो चीज़ें है, कारपेट वगैरह है, वो दुपट्टा ड्रेसेस है, वो कई सारी चीज़ें अभी थोड़ी खरीदी है, अभी थोड़ी खरीदने की बाकी है और बहुत अच्छा लगा यहाँ शॉपिंग करके।
Initiatives like these have been successful in providing a market and a platform to many artisans to showcase their product and derive profits. Last but not the least, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings across Asia in our new edition, Asia in Focus.
It's not a bird, it's not a plane, it's a drone made partly from pineapple leaves. The design is part of a sustainability project at Malaysia's Putra University led by Professor Mohammad Tariq Hamid Sultan. Tariq's team used discarded pineapple leaves to create the skeleton of aerial drones.
The next step would be to develop a slightly larger drone to be able to carry some payload, which would carry some imagery sensor and even some other payloads that would benefit the typical farmer around here. So our role here is to help the industry, help the farmers to actually explore into force IR, technology and innovations that would help them increase their yield and make their jobs much easier.
Tariq says the drones are currently able to fly up to about 1,000 meters height and stay in the air for about 20 minutes. According to researchers, drones made from natural materials or biocompositions are tougher, lighter, cheaper and easier to dispose. Thousands of Catholic devotees observe physical distancing as they stood in lines for morning masses in the Philippine capital to celebrate a centuries-old black wooden statue of Jesus Christ believed to bring miracles to the faithful. With the coronavirus pandemic afflicting the country, authorities cancelled an annual procession of the life-size image of Black Nazarene, the country's largest religious event that draws millions of devotees in an annual ritual observed for 200 years. Instead, church leaders organized 15 masses at the Kwai Po Church, which houses the life-size statue, and live-streamed the worship services, pleading for devotees not to flock into the basilica.
Ang pinagdasal ko sa tao ngayon, sa personal ko, good health kami mga pamilya, tapos maging maayos kami lahat. Tapos lahat ng walang kaaway tayo, tapos maging mabuti ng takbo ng Pilipinas sa 2021 na to. Walang COVID, matanggal na lahat ng sakit, COVID, mawala. Tapos peace and order, walang gulo, walang krimen, yun lang importante sa akin.
About 80% of the country's 108 million people identify as Roman Catholic, a legacy of hundreds of years as a Spanish colony. Factory workers and surgeons whose jobs required them to stand for hours in one place could see relief from leg and back pain in the form of wearable exoskeleton leg device from Japanese startup Archilles. The device which Archilles is showcasing at the CES Virtual Tech and Gadget Show stripes the legs and disperses the wearer's body weight so it's supported by the shins and thighs, making standing easier and less tiring. The Archilles FX device, whose name derives from the Japanese from walkable chair, is all mechanical and does not require any electricity to operate. It could also be used by chefs, hairdressers or anyone who is required to stand for long periods, Saho said. Saho himself uses it while working on his computer at a standing desk. Archilles FX is scheduled for a market release in January 2021 and it will retail for around $5,000.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at mindia@nin.com. I'm your host, Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.